everyone! Today we're gonna guide you through the first steps of using phase. First, we'll be unboxing phase to present you every single item included in the box. Then we'll provide you with the best tips and tricks to configure your product in the most optimal way according to your setup. Let's go! When you open your phase box for the first time, you see that it includes one phase receiver and two remotes. Simply lift the top and underneath you'll find a pocket, including a quick start guide, brand stickers, and most importantly, the four magnetic stickers for your records. You'll also find one USB and two RCA cables. So now, let's start with charging your phase. Before configuring your phase for the first time, we recommend you fully charge your remotes. This is a standard practice to ensure the best durability of your battery. To charge your remotes, simply plug in your receiver to your laptop via USB. 2 hours are usually necessary to complete the charge. Once they're 100% charged, your remotes can last up to 10 hours. You can also use a power outlet, but for this tutorial, we'll be using a laptop in order to configure your product while it charges. When the LEDs of your remotes and the receiver are slowly flashing, it means your phase is charging properly. While it's charging, let's configure your phase. To begin with, you need to download Phase Manager, the dedicated app where you can configure, update, and customize your phase. You can download it directly on phasedj.com/configuration. For this tutorial, we'll be using the macOS Phase Manager version, but both PC and Mac versions are completely the same. Note though that Phase Manager is supported by macOS 10.10 and above, and Windows 10 and above. Open the app and create an account to access it, or log in into yours if you already have one. If you just registered, don't forget to check all your inbox tabs as well as spam folders to validate your email. On the main view, you'll notice that your phase is now connected and recognized by Phase Manager. If your phase is not properly detected by Phase Manager, try to reconnect your unit by unplugging and re-plugging the USB cable. If it doesn't work, please contact our product specialist. Phase is regularly improved throughout firmware updates with additional new features to upgrade your experience. Thus, it is very, very important to always keep your unit up to date. Whenever an update is available, a red button will indicate it and guide you to the update center. Click on Update My Phase and follow the steps displayed. Check out our dedicated tutorial on updating your phase if you want to know more. Now that your phase is up to date, you need to make sure your remotes are properly linked to the receiver to communicate. To do so, with the remotes in the receiver decks, long press the Setup AB buttons. The remotes are linked to the receiver when the LEDs stop blinking and their colors match their respective deck button. This notion means that the remotes are placed in their corresponding decks. When you take the remotes out of the receiver, you'll notice that the respective AB buttons turns white, whereas the remote LEDs keep their color. This behavior is completely normal. Once linked to the receiver, the remotes remain connected to their decks even when the phase is turned off. Now that your phase is charged and up to date, let's explore the ways you can personalize it. In the Phase Manager settings, select the DJ software you're about to use. Note that Serato is selected by default, so you don't have to change a thing if you're using it. In the Color tab, you can change the colors of your remotes to your taste. And now, let's get to the most exciting part you've all been waiting for. You'll be happy to know that Phase is compatible with any DVS setup. Firstly, we'll show you how to set up Phase with Serato DJ Pro using the HID mode. Then, we'll show you how to connect it using the DVS mode with all the other DJ software, such as Tractor, Recordbox, or Virtual DJ. It only takes a few steps to set up your phase with Serato DJ Pro via HID mode. Not only does it offer an easier way to set up, as you don't need the RCA cables anymore, it also provides you with the best experience in terms of latency and accuracy. To use phase with Serato DJ Pro via HID, you require a primary device that enables DVS. Also, your Serato DJ Pro needs to be 2.5 or above. Make sure your phase is properly up to date as well. Plug the receiver into your laptop via USB and open Serato DJ Pro. Then, select the wireless mode WIR off the virtual decks, specifically designed for phase. And that's it! If you'd like to learn more about the dedicated features of this integration, well, we have a video just for that. So now, let's take a look at how to set it up with other DJ software using a DVS connection with the RCAs. If you're using a mixer with a built-in DVS interface, connect the audio outputs of the receiver to the line inputs of your mixer using the RCAs. Set your mixer source selector to USB PC according to a USB port you're using. Then, the way you're setting up your phase is exactly the same way as with your classic DVS setup. Set the virtual decks of your DJ software in relative mode. The process is the same with an analog mixer, but with the sound card in between. Simply connect the receiver's output channels to the input channels of the sound card, and then the sound card's output channels to the line inputs of your mixer. Now that you're all set, take out two magnetic stickers off the pocket and remove the protective tab. Now you can place the stickers on the top of your records to ensure the remotes remain steadily attached during the performance. You can always buy additional magnetic stickers from our website or from your favorite DJ store, if you ever need more. When taken out of the receiver, your remotes will automatically start calibrating. Place them on a plain and still surface until their LEDs turn solid. It is important to keep the remotes motionless during this moment to ensure the most accurate calibration of your remote's sensors. Once the LEDs turn solid, your remotes are properly calibrated and ready to use. As phase is composed of very sensitive and accurate sensors, one of the best practices we suggest is to manually calibrate them from time to time. To do so, go to the Calibration tab in the Phase Manager settings and follow the instructions to run the manual calibration. This ensures that the speed of the remotes always matches the speed of the turntables. And here you go, ready for your first gig with phase. We hope this video has given you a complete overview to get to know your phase better. If you're looking for further info, don't hesitate to check our official user manual. You will find more details about the features and configuration instructions. This guide is downloadable on our website, phasedj.com, or via the link in the video description. Check your volumes, load your tracks, and let's hit it!